A cold front is sweeping through New York, but the Isles are ready to heat things up here in Brooklyn with a Western Conference matchup against the Chicago Blackhawks. It's their first meeting of the year and the only time they're going to play this season here at Barclays Center.
Boychuk coming in on the wall, giving problems to Rasmussen. Kempe trying the other side now. Good pressure here by the Islanders as the point's able to keep it in. And now it's Quine in front. They score! It's Andrew Ladd against his former team. And the Islanders make quick work tonight.
Now you talk about aggressive forechecking. It starts with Thomas Hickey pinching in along the left boards, keeping the puck alive. And then Chimera makes an absolutely brilliant pass to Alan Quine. And then he threads the needle to Andrew Ladd, and he makes absolutely no mistake. And Andrew Ladd, we talked about him being a slow starter, starting to heat up.
Blackhawks have won back-to-back, including beating the Rangers on Tuesday. Turnover, here's Kuhlman and Cizikas trying to join. Kuhlman shot, rebound was there, score! It's Casey Cizikas, and the Islanders have scored twice in the opening 4 minutes.
The Islanders have come out in a real vengeance on their mind. Skating, and that was a quick two-on-one. Kuhlman makes the right decision. He shoots the puck, but he hits the net, forces Darling to make a save, and Cizikas takes it on the backhand right from their own zone. There's the interception, the turnover. Look at the turn of speed by Kuhlman. He takes a look, lets the shot go, and Cizikas stays with it.
Through that 15, 20-second time in your own zone.
Saw the numbers for Kane. His 8 points in the power play lead the Blackhawks this season as Panarin blasts one home. The one-timer set up for Panarin in the bottom of the circle, and Greiss had no chance to get back for that one.
Yeah, it all starts with a face-off win, and then a seam pass. The Islanders couldn't get into the shooting lane, and Panarin, who loves to one-time that puck as well as anybody.
Anisimov to Kane, floated out for Keith, 47 left on the power play. Panarin across, Kane to the front, Anisimov will touch it in and tie it. The Blackhawks, courtesy of two power play goals, have come back, and we're still in the first period.
I mean, he was out of the National Hockey League. He spent most of a year in Grand Rapids, the American Hockey League, trying to get back in, and has come back and been a regular player again.
Tished in front, and Marian Hossa has given the Blackhawks their third straight goal here in the first period.
Chicago Blackhawks lose the faceoff, and the Islanders have control. A little mishap. Little pinch quickly, and then the quick puck movement from Jonathan Toews to Hartman. He knows exactly where Marian Hossa is, and that's just a two-foot gimme as far as I'm concerned. Look at the play behind the back. He's not looking to find Hossa. He knows he's already there, so the Islanders turn the puck over in their own zone, and they pay a price.
3 goals on 10 shots for the Blackhawks, 2 on 8 for the Islanders. Boychuk put it towards the net. It was knocked down. Prince overskated. Strome will backhand it behind the net.
And it's not like Thomas Greiss is playing poorly. I mean, all three of those goals,
no chance. There's a friendly bounce for the Islanders. And Ryan Strome will get one from nearly in the neutral zone.
There's the puck. It's deflected off of Panik and gets past Darling. So Ryan Strome is on the scoreboard. As you can see that Panik deflects it back to Darling's left. He's not able to pick it up quite in time as he screened just a little bit in front of him.
Rimmed around the boards behind Scott Darling. After a period like that, it's worth pointing out, same two goaltenders that started the hockey game still in the nets. Here with Thomas Greiss and Darling. As a shot from Hamonic, redirected and scores! Anders Lee with the tip, and it took just 22 seconds to find another goal. It's 4-3 Isles.
There's a shot by Travis Hamonic, the tip downwards. And then Josh Bailey's in front of the net. He's able to pick that puck. Well, I guess he just doesn't get it. Looked like he might get a piece of it and be able to drive it in between the net, but that goes off the post. A little screenplay by Josh Bailey. Anders Lee gets credit for the goal. Friends with Jonathan Toews back in Winnipeg, and he says they're both the same. They're both so tenacious. They never stop working. It's just miserable having one-on-one drills with them.
Tavares to the slot. Bailey's alone. Backhand was stuck. Try. Darling has it under him on the Hamonic opportunity. Two Islanders alone in front of the goal, and Scott Darling emerges with the puck. Gives it off for Kane. 24 seconds to go in the period. To the front, Seabrook has it. Panarin's one-timer scores. He's got two power play goals tonight. It's the third power play goal for the Blackhawks, and it's a 4-4 tie here in the closing minute of the second period.
trying to escape the pressure from Strome. All the way behind the net will lead for Brian Campbell. His 17th NHL season. Pass on for Rasmussen. Into the skates of Panic. Nifty kick to get it up to his stick. And then he is shown the ice by DeHaan. In front, Panic scores! That puck popped to the slot, and Richard Panic, with only 6:13 remaining, give the Blackhawks a 5-4 lead.
Now the Islanders have control, and the Chicago Blackhawks go to work with the forecheck. And Kruger and Rasmussen force the turnover. There's Kruger on the forecheck. DeHaan has it. Support by Rasmussen, and Panic just goes to the slot as the Islanders aren't able to get back in time to cover up. Josh Bailey's back there.
Tied up, cleared down. No icing.
And that's going to do it.
The Chicago Blackhawks, courtesy of a third period goal, a 5-4 win over the Islanders tonight.
Well, this will be a very frustrated loss for the Islanders. As I mentioned, played a very strong game, did a lot of good things out there, and then make a mistake late in the hockey game, the turnover in behind the goal, and they find themselves at the bad end of this hockey game tonight after showing a real good display of offense.